See, now we are going to discuss about need for classification. See here, now we are going to discuss about need for classification. Actually, what is a need for classification? See here, if you take the living organisms on the earth, they are all different types of groups. So studying about all the living organisms in a single category is not possible. Means it is impossible to study about all the living organisms in a single category. So that is why living organisms should be divided into different types of groups. So that is called as classification. See here, the meaning of classification is, classification is a process by which anything can be divided into convenient group by the observable simple characters. Means here, for the better understanding, to understand all the living organisms, so we have to divide the living organisms into groups or categories. How we are dividing them into categories? By the simple observable character. So classification is a process by which anything can be divided into our convenient group by simply observable category or characters. So here, the group into which you are arranging an animal is called as taxon. So taxon is single, taxa is plural. So here, generally all the living organisms are divided into different types of taxa. Okay, so this is a need for classification. So here, whenever you want to understand about the living organisms, if they are separated into different types of categories or groups, then you can easily understand, then you can easily study about the living organisms. So that is a classification is needed for better understand. Next, if you take juice as tools for classification. So here, how the juice helps for classification? So before going to that, we have to know what are zoos. Generally, zoos are the places in which the organisms are taken out of their own habitat or natural habitat and kept in this particular area which is under human protection or human concern. So zoos are the places where the wild animals are taken out of their habitats or natural habitats and kept in a particular area, the area which is under the control of the human being. So here, when the animals are taken out of their original habitat and kept in the zoos, it helps for study. So when you are keeping the animals in the zoos, that will help you to study about their habitat, means where they are living, their habits, physiology, especially behavior and their evolution. Generally, zoos helps for the study of so many things regarding the animals. So zoos as tools for classification, zoos are helping for the purpose of classification. So this is zoos as tools for the classification. Next, if you see museums. Sir, here museums are the places where biological specimens are preserved. See, some of the biological specimens are preserved in containers, jars, they are preserved. For example, if you take insects, insects are preserved in the insect boxes. in the insect boxes. Means insects first they collected, then killed by pinning. Pinning means keeping a head pin on the body. They are placed on a sheet. So by these insects are preserved. The dead bodies of the insects are preserved by collecting that, after that killing and pinning the head on their head and keeping them on the sheets. So by that insects can be preserved. And some of the animals like birds, other mammals can be preserved in the form of stuffed animals. They preserved in the form of stuffed animals. See how the stuffed animals are prepared, especially birds and mammals are preserved in the form of stuffed animals. Stuffed animals means when an animal is collected, all the viscera will be removed from the abdomen region, husk or cotton is kept in the body, then it is preserved in the museums. So museums are the places where some dead bodies of the animals are preserved in the containers or jars or in the form of stuffed animals. So museums also helps for the classification. Next, zoos also helps for the classification. So here these are the two things which helps us to classify the animals. Okay, so classification is a process by which any organism can be divided into convenient group by the simple observable characters. So this is about the need for classification.